Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Here is Jules from Uncage the Mice. Did you already ask yourself what a strange name for the YouTube channel? Well, let me explain. There is actually a sad story behind it. When I was in my bachelor studies, I attended a course named Radio Ecology. We were invited to the Russian Military Medical Academy, to the Toxicological Department. The head of this department showed us around, and I remember we entered student auditorium. There was a glass box on the table, and he explained that they need this to show students how poison and how antidote works. I had a scary picture in my head. Just imagine, your life will end in sake of 5 minutes stupid and obvious experiment just as normal part of the lecture. Scared, father worse. We went to the basement. There were cages everywhere. In these cages, mice. The red dots on their backs indicated that they were given radioactive substances. I was terrified. I was angry. I felt frustrated. Now when I'm looking back, I'm thinking, what would I do in this situation? Liberate them from this cruel system. I would uncage the mice. So in memory of these poor little creatures and in sake of justice, I decided to name my channel Uncage the Mice. Today I would like to draw your attention to the movement against the animal experimentation. Tracking back the movement, first the opposition had anti-vivisection motives, and again, first regulations of animal testing came from the welfare. For example, in 1876, Britain passes the Cruelty to Animals Act, which was quite controversial though. It regulated the licenses given for cruel experiments, stated that experiments must be conducted only under anesthesia and not for gaining skills or performed in schools. However, they also stated that animals need to be killed directly after experiment.
How controversial is that?
Similar American Welfare Act was passed in 1966. But now, let's move on to the animal rights campaigns. In 1970s, Richard Rider was impressed by the incidents he witnessed in the laboratories, and he wrote letters to the Daily Telegraph criticizing animal experimentation. He also distributed pamphlets in the Oxford. That wasn't enough for making a change. Let's look at another example. Henry Spira, the former seaman and civil rights activist, became a notable animal advocate in the 1980s in the United States. His organization, Animal Rights International, founded in 1974, leads a successful campaign to end harmful experiments performed on cats for 20 years at the American Museum of Natural History.
Okay, stop here.
That was the very first successful campaign against animal experimentation. The question is how the goal was achieved. First of all, animal rights groups made an 80 months long picket in front of the named museum. Secondly, Spira convinced the congressman that reported to the Congress the cruel experiments, where 112 members questioned the sense of this experiment. And as a result, National Institute of Health withheld the funding from this research. About a year later, the laboratory was closed. The next Spira's campaign was successful as well. In 1980, he convinced the cosmetics company Relon to stop using trace tests.
The trace test, an acute toxicity test in which a substance is introduced into the eye or applied to the skin of an animal in order to ascertain the likely effect of this substance on the corresponding human tissue.
Howe, he took a full-page advertisement in several newspapers featuring a rabbit with sticking plaster over the eye and saying, "How many rabbits does Revlon blind for the beauty's sake?" Revlon stopped experiments on animals and donated money to set up a center for alternatives. It was followed by other leading cosmetics companies. Just to let you know, guys, here is a current map of animal testing policies in the world. And as you can see, the orange have absolutely no ban, no regulations on animal testing. And this is most of the countries. by the way. Later on in 1990s, Animal Rights International was working on abolishing the LD50 death test, but many scientists considered unproductive and unnecessary. Animal Rights International activists combined working with leading scientists and regulators, and at the same time pressuring corporate sector. As a result, within a decade, in vitro or non-animal toxicology entered the mainstream in science and reduced animal experiments by 60%. Let us now move to the 2020 and the modern movement against animal experimentation. The most known case in 2019-2020 is Zookoterapeuts' protest against 50 years animal lab experiments in the laboratories of pharmacology and toxicology, or LPT, in Germany. After revealing horrific experiments on dogs, cats, monkeys, Zookoterapeuts organized the greatest demonstrations with thousands of participants. As well as peaceful vigils in front of the laboratories. They even conducted a demonstration with powerful speech where participants were holding dead animals from the lab. One after another, the laboratories were closed and animals sent to the sanctuaries. What can we learn from this? What is the take-home message? First, animal rights activists need to collect the footage and information on animal abuse. Second, it should be shown to the public. And third, we need to mobilize the public. Big demonstrations, vigils and pickets reflect the strong position of public and often leads to the success. Thank you for watching me. Subscribe, share, give me a thumbs up, and I see you next time. Bye!